There's 5 steps to setting up Amazon PPC, and I'm going to show you how to do it in just 4 minutes. I've been putting off setting up Amazon PPC for my new product, and I've just been overcomplicating it in my head. But setting up Amazon PPC is easy and it's extremely powerful, so I decided to challenge myself in this week's Tactical Vlog Thursday video. This video right here, I'm going to show you live as I set up PPC for my new Amazon FBA product in just 4 minutes. And the reason that Amazon PPC is so powerful is because when people are searching for things on Amazon, you can show up right at the top of the search results. And in fact, sponsored products, you can tell it's an Amazon PPC product if it says sponsored on it. Sponsored products show up before the regular organic search results. So this is an extremely powerful tool to increase your sales. And there's 5 things that I'm going to go over in this tutorial video. The first thing we're going to talk about is setting up an automatic campaign, which is the easiest campaign to set up. It's one of the most powerful, one of the most profitable campaigns, and it has some added bonuses I'll talk about later in this video. Then I'm going to talk about how to do keyword research, because the way Amazon PPC works is people search for different keywords. For instance, performance nut butter would be the keyword someone is searching for. Then that triggers certain ads. So when people search for this keyword, it triggers my ads. Obviously, there's other keywords as well that I target and I show up for, but you get to decide what keywords you want your product to show up for, and you have to pay for it. Now, keep that in mind. Every time someone clicks on an ad on Amazon PPC, it charges the company a certain amount of money. So if I were to click on this ad, which I won't do, it would charge this person probably a dollar or so just for me to see their product page. So you pay every time. That's why it's pay per click. Then the third thing I'm going to show you is how to set up keyword targeted ads. So the automatic campaign just automatically targets different keywords that Amazon thinks that you'll make sales from, but you can also target specific keywords. You can also do product targeting, and product targeting campaigns are really powerful as well because they actually show up. They make it so your product will show up down here in the sponsored products related to this item. So if you want your product to show up on your competitors' products, this is a very powerful way to do it. And then the last thing I'm going to talk about is negative keywords, which is something that so many people forget about. But if you don't add negative keywords, you are wasting money. So let's dive into it and start the clock. The first thing you're going to do is go up here to Campaign Manager. Once you're in here, you're going to click Create Campaign. And the first campaign, as I mentioned, we're going to do is an automatic campaign, which is so easy to set up. You're going to click Sponsored Products. Now, pause for a second. I will do a future video talking about sponsored brands and sponsored display, but Sponsored Products is the easiest type of campaign to set up. And honestly, I think it's probably one of the most profitable, one of the most powerful ones. These ones can be very, very powerful as well, but I'll save that for a future video. So you'll click Continue because we're going to do Sponsored Products here. And you'll name your campaign name. It doesn't matter what you name it. I'm just going to put PNB Cacao Test 1. And we're gonna do a daily budget. I recommend starting with $10 to $20. Let's put $20. And you're gonna wanna make sure that it says automatic targeting. We'll do the future ones, we'll talk about manual targeting. This is a more advanced topic I'll save for next week's video. I'm doing a video next week going in depth, a complete tutorial video. We're gonna go here, we'll just do this test one, doesn't matter. And then you select what product you wanna advertise for. So this is my new product I just launched. So I'm gonna click that, scroll down, and you set what the default bid is. Every time someone clicks on your ad, how much money do you want to spend? And I could put 75 cents. It suggests a bid of 177. I'd say, you know, start with maybe the suggested bid and then play with it. Now, an advanced thing you can do as well is set bids by targeting group. And there's all these different ways of targeting, and you can get little information about all these, but close match will automatically target keywords that are close match. Loose match will automatically target keywords that Amazon thinks is a loose match, and you can set different bids. But an even more powerful thing to do is set up different campaigns or different ad groups for each one of these. So you can turn them off and turn them on. So maybe this one, I just want to target compliments. Let's go 76 cents and launch the campaign. And boom, just like that, we're done with the first step, which is setting up an automatic campaign. Now, I will obviously talk later about adding negative keywords, which is very important, but let's talk about how to do keyword research, because obviously the automatic campaign is going to target whatever keywords Amazon thinks is relevant, but we don't want to just let Amazon decide what they think is relevant. We want to target certain keywords as well. So how do you find these keywords? Well, I'd recommend Helium 10 or Jungle Scout Or if you don't want to pay for either one of those tools, you don't have to. You can use the Google Keyword Planner. And I'll link videos. I've done videos comparing Helium 10 and Jungle Scout. And I've also done videos on how to use the Keyword Planner to do keyword research. But once you've done keyword research and you have your keywords, it's time to set up the next type of campaign, which is keyword targeted sponsored products. So we're going to go create campaign again. We'll click on sponsored products. And again, name it whatever you want. Test 1, 2, 3. Daily budget of whatever you think, the max that you want to spend per day while you're in the testing phase. And here's the trick. You're going to click manual targeting. We don't want the automatic targeting for this campaign. And another trick I didn't mention, if you want to do keyword research, you can actually let Amazon help you with the keyword research. Go in here again. You can change the ad group name if you want for just ease of use. We're going to scroll down. And Amazon actually recommends a bunch of different keywords. So I might want to go macadamia cashew butter. Boom, that's a good one. Keto nut butter singles, that's another good one. But if for whatever reason, Amazon doesn't recommend certain keywords that you think is good, you can click enter list and you can paste a list of all the keywords that you want to target. For me, I came up with this list. We're going to click add keywords. And one thing you're going to want to do is make sure you change the bid that you're willing to pay. So for this one, every time someone searches for nut butter and they see my ad and they click on my ad, I'd be paying on average about $1.55. And I can change that. Maybe I say, wow, that's way too much money. You can adjust it here. But once you've done that, you can click launch campaign. Now, something I didn't talk about is the difference between a broad match, exact match, and phrase match. I'll talk about that later in this video. But the last type of campaign we want to set up is product targeting, which I showed you earlier, a very powerful thing. It allows you to show up in your competitor's product page, basically. And the way we're going to do that, and you can use Helium 10, and I believe Jungle Scout also has a feature to help you find products to target, but Amazon itself has a tool that'll allow you to do that. I'll show you how to do this right now. Again, we'll click on sponsored products, type in the campaign name here, set the daily budget, let's say $20, manual targeting. Again, we're going to skip this part here. It's more advanced. You don't really need to mess around with this too much. You can add an ad group name if you want. Select the product. We're still doing it for my new product, the PNB Cacao. And we're going to instead click product targeting. And you can basically target entire categories. So if I wanted to, every single product that's in the cashew butter, I could target that if I wanted to. Or instead, I could go after individual products. And Amazon gives you a list of products that it thinks is relevant, but you know, some of these are not relevant in my opinion. I do see a competitor of mine. I'm definitely going to target them. I'm going to go through and target a few other products that seem related to my product. Or, as always, you can enter a list. If you have a list of ASINs, and you can get those again by using Helium 10, Jungle Scout, or just searching around on Amazon, finding similar products, you can put it in here. And once you're done, you can scroll down, and again, you can set how much you're willing to pay per click. So every time someone sees your ad on a competitor's page and clicks on yours, you can say, I'm willing to pay 61 cents, whatever it is. Once you're done with that, you're going to hit launch campaign. And now this last thing is one of the most important things that so many people forget about. And especially with the automatic campaign, but honestly, I think with all types of campaigns, you want to make sure that you're adding negative keywords. And negative keywords basically says, if someone searches for certain keywords, I want my ad to show up as long as it doesn't include the negative keywords. For instance, I want my ad to show up for performance nut butter because that's my brand name. But if someone types in cheap performance nut butter, I don't want my ad to show up because my product's not a cheap product. So anyone looking for anything related to cheap, they should not get to see my product. So the way to add negative keywords is we're going to go in here, click on the negative keywords for the campaign, add negative keywords, and just paste in a list. I usually like to do negative phrase. Again, though, that's a topic for the detailed tutorial video I'll do on Tuesday. Add the keywords, save, and right there, that's gonna save you a lot of money. Make sure you do this for your automatic campaign, absolutely, and any keyword targeted campaigns as well, it's very helpful for. And as far as how do you find the negative keywords, again, Helium 10, Jungle Scout, or if you wanna go the free route, the Google Keyword Planner. And I do have the hookup with both Helium 10 and Jungle Scout. I'll put the links down below. I have discounted rates, better than any other discount rate I've seen out there. So you can click on those links to see my discounted rate, but you don't need it. You can always use the Google Keyword Planner for a lot of this stuff. But now I want to share with you my three top Amazon PPC tips. But before I do, if you've enjoyed this video so far, smash that like button. It lets me know that you've enjoyed this video, and it also lets Google know that this has been a valuable video for you. And the first tip I have for you is add negative keywords. I've seen so many people skip this step and so many people lose so much money. And it hurts me when I see people running ads without the negative keywords, because there's certain keywords that you know are not going to convert for you. And you want to make sure you add those as negative keywords. My second tip is just do it. Just set up at least the automatic campaign. What that's going to do for you is it's going to allow you to start getting data. The automatic campaign will be running and you'll see, oh, I got a sale from this keyword. I got a sale from this keyword. And once you get a sale from a certain keyword, you can set up a new campaign, target it, and basically know you can adjust how much you want to pay for that certain keyword. Because the automatic campaign doesn't allow you to do the fine tuning, but once you find winners, certain keywords that you know sell, take it out of the automatic campaign, put it into its own keyword targeted campaign, and then you can fine tune exactly how much money you're willing to spend on that. Now, before I get into the final and probably the most important tip, make sure to smash that subscribe button, because like I said, next week I'm going to be coming out with a full length tutorial video on Amazon PPC. This video was obviously rushed. I was trying to do it in really quick, but also smash that like button, because every Thursday I'm going to start sharing with you exactly what I'm doing to grow my sales for my Amazon business and show you all the tactics that I'm actually using to grow my brand. So it's going to be a real-time thing where I show you what I'm doing and you'll get to see week by week, is it working or is it not working? So smash that subscribe button. I made a complete checklist to help you in setting up your Amazon PPC, which you can get for free. I'll put a link down below where you can get that checklist for free. And if you get the checklist, I'll also send you a free in-depth training, much more in-depth than we went over here, on some of the more advanced features of Amazon PPC. So click to get that checklist and that in-depth training video. And remember to enjoy the journey. I'll see you guys next time. And thanks so much for watching.